Microservices architecture breaks down monolithic large applications into smaller, independent, and decoupled services. Each service handles a specific business function. This architecture offers many benefits like better scalability and faster development and deployment cycles. But it also introduces a challenge. How do external clients like web applications or mobile apps interact with all these individual services? One simple approach is for the client to communicate directly with microservices. That may be fine for small systems, but what if we have hundreds or thousands of microservices? This direct communication approach has several drawbacks. Clients often need data from multiple services, leading to many round trips over the network, which increases latency and decreases performance. If microservices are updated or refactored, it may require changes in every client that communicates directly with them. Common functionalities like authorization, rate limiting, and logging, etc., need to be handled for each microservice. Implementing these consistently is difficult and repetitive. Finally, allowing direct calls to microservices expands the attack surface that could be exploited by malicious actors. The API gateway design pattern is the most common way to address these challenges. An API gateway provides a single, consistent interface for external clients to interact with a complex network of microservices. It manages all incoming requests and outgoing responses. So, what exactly does an API gateway accomplish? It typically handles several essential tasks. Request routing is the main role of an API gateway. It acts like a traffic controller, routing incoming requests to the correct microservice. After receiving a request, the API gateway can orchestrate multiple calls to services, then aggregate the responses before returning it to the client. This reduces chattiness and simplifies client-side logic. Handling cross-cutting concerns is an important responsibility for an API gateway. It centralizes logic for tasks that apply across services like authentication and authorization, rate limiting and throttling, caching, logging, monitoring and tracing, SSL termination, and even API subscriptions and monetization. By offloading these concerns to the gateway, individual microservices can remain simpler and focus purely on their core business logic. Protocol translation. The gateway can translate between different communication protocols. For example, clients might communicate with the gateway using standard REST APIs, while the gateway communicates with the backend services using gRPC or asynchronous messaging. Finally, the gateway provides a stable API interface for clients, insulating them from changes or refactoring happening in the backend microservices. While very powerful, the API gateway pattern isn't a silver bullet. It introduces its own drawbacks. It is clearly a single point of failure. If the gateway goes down, all client access is blocked. Therefore, it must be designed for high availability and redundancy. It could also be a potential bottleneck. Since all traffic flows through it, the gateway needs to be highly performant and scalable. We also need to consider that the gateway is another critical component that needs to be developed, deployed, monitored, and maintained. And finally, there is a temptation to put too much business logic or complex orchestration inside the gateway itself. It should primarily focus on routing and edge concerns, not become a new monolith. The API gateway pattern is a crucial component in many microservice architectures. It acts as a single entry point, simplifying client interactions, centralizing cross-cutting concerns, and decoupling clients from back-end complexities. However, it also introduces its own operational complexity and potential bottlenecks that need careful consideration. Understanding when and how to use an API gateway effectively is key to building robust and manageable microservice-based systems.